Hey guys, I want to show you something I've been working on. I haven't made a video in a few days because I've been working on this pretty intensively and I'm trying to get it updated. But if you go to my website, I have now made a section where there are tutorials for some of the Black Ops 2 and Black Ops 1 maps. Once you get to this page, you can see there's all these different maps here. You just click on the picture and it will take you into that specific map and show you the tutorials. So if you click on Origins, you're going to see the staff tutorials. I'm also adding the Easter egg right now, so I'm just working on that and I'll update it as soon as I'm done. I'm trying to help to provide like a central location for people to like easily access the information for these steps for the different maps. The website should support all kinds of different skill levels. So if you're pretty good at Origins, but you just don't remember like the codes and symbols for the staffs, those quick guides that have just all the graphics are going to help you a lot. For people that are really new to Black Ops 2 and Black Ops 1, and believe it or not, I have met people that have never played Origins. They've just played Black Ops 3 and that's it. There's some written tutorials below those graphics that are going to be more in depth. Also in this video, I'm just going to do a really fast speed tutorial of how to build each of the staffs. And this video is going to go on that website just in case, you know, somebody doesn't want to see the graphics. They don't want to read. They just want to hear how to do it. Also on my website, I've started a blog and I'm calling it Zlog because of zombies. And it's just going to talk about like behind the scenes stuff for me, like what I'm working on for videos, what I think about, you know, stuff that's in the media. Just, you know, I can't put everything on Twitter. There's not enough room. So I really want to be able to talk to you guys and let y'all know what's going on behind the scenes with me. You know, merchandise that I'm working on and some inside information. And I'll try to keep this updated every day. And you just go to glitchingqueen.com and that should be an option up at the top for the blog. Now onto the speed tutorial for the staffs. And again, hopefully this will just help people refresh their memories and give them a quick, you know, chart to reference when they're doing some of the steps that are difficult to remember. And I figured a newer video would be easier to find. And I'm gonna have this on a playlist on my YouTube channel. Again, this chart is also gonna be on my website and I'm gonna go over the steps really quickly for you guys right here. For the fire staff, you need to obtain the record. It's gonna be at the church by the tank and the stairs. It's gonna be upstairs on these benches. And the third location is gonna be by generator 6. The next step is to obtain the three staff pieces, and one of them can be obtained by shooting down the plane that's flying above. It's going to be glowing red, and you can't do this until round 3. It's going to land between the footprints below excavation. You can pick it up there. The next staff piece can be obtained by turning on generator 6 out by the church. It'll come out of the chest. The last piece is obtained by killing the Panzer. Once he dies, he's going to drop it and you can pick it up. At this point, you should have excavation open and obtain the gramophone. And you're going to want to go to the red tunnel, which is by spawn, place the gramophone and enter Agartha. It's going to make this crystal appear and you can pick it up. Go all the way to the bottom of excavation, build the staff in its pedestal and pick it up. In Agartha, you want to light these four cauldrons up by killing zombies on top of this grate with the fire staff. You have to kill between 20 and 30 zombies. I don't know the exact number, but once you have all four of them lit, you'll know you'll be done. Next step is to go to the church and go upstairs. There's going to be symbols on the walls, and these represent numbers, and some of them will be lit up and some of them won't. You can use the chart to know which numbers it's representing. Then you go to the first floor, use the fire staff, and very quickly light up the torches that correspond with these numbers. Once that's complete, you can go to the bottom of excavation and use the levers to turn these dials all to the red stone. A red ball will appear, just shoot it with the fire staff, and then you can head into Agartha and feed 20 zombies to the staff, and it will be complete. And you can pick it up. The next staff speed tutorial will be the wind staff, and here's the quick reference guide. Again, this will be on the website, but the first step is to get the record. This record will randomly spawn around generator 5. One is going to be on this ledge next to stamina. The other is going to be on this box right here as you enter generator 5, and the last one is going to be in the lightning tunnel entrance on the left on this bench. All three wind staff pieces are obtained inside of the robot heads, so you have to teleport into each of them. You have to go into Odin, Thor, and also Freya. Now head to the wind tunnel and use the gramophone to enter that teleporter to get into Agartha and pick up the windstaff crystal. Go to the bottom of excavation and build the windstaff and pick it up. Go back into Agartha and use the windstaff and stand by the AK-74U wall gun by that is on the left, and you want to line up these symbols like this. I find this easy to remember if you imagine that you're spelling the word fill. These symbols do seem to represent these letters, and this one I never have to have memorized. I always just know to spell this word and it works every time. Now go back outside, use the windstaff and shoot these smoking domes. You want to shoot the one at generator 4 towards excavation. This one right here is outside of the church on the tank track. Again, shoot towards excavation. This one here is the entrance of generator 5. You can just stand here and shoot it and it will complete it. Now go to the bottom of excavation and turn all the dials to the yellow stone. You're going to see the yellow ball drop down. Shoot it with the windstaff. Head to Agartha and place the windstaff in the pedestal. Feed 20 zombies to it and it will be complete. The next staff speed tutorial will be the lightning staff. Here's the quick reference guide that will be on the website also. The record location for the lightning staff is going to be located around generator 4. So it's going to be on this bench here next to Jug, on the back of this wagon as you enter generator 4, and then at the bottom of the wind tunnel on the right. The staff pieces are obtained by riding the tank and jumping off to these locations. Make sure this one right here by spawn, you have that area opened or you'll hit a death barrier. The second is here by excavation and the third is inside of the church. Now grab the gramophone and head to generator 5. You're going to take the lightning tunnel down and open up that portal. Go into Agartha and pick up the lightning staff crystal. You're ready to build the staff, so just go below excavation, go to the pedestal, build it, and pick it up. Now take the staff and go into Agartha and play the lightning staff piano. I've got the keys here labeled as numbers, so it makes it a lot easier. And all you have to do is, you know, shoot the lightning staff at the corresponding numbers, and you only have to do 3 sets of numbers. And you don't have to do these in any particular order. You just need to enter the 3 numbers and then give it a second to register. So the 136, you could enter 361 or 613. It doesn't matter. Just do those 3 numbers, wait, and you can move on to the next set. The next step is to go around to 7 panels around the map and turn the dials to a certain direction. You don't have to do this in any particular order, but I've made a chart here, so hopefully it'll make it a lot easier. Now head to the bottom of excavation and turn all the dials until you see all purple stones. You'll see the purple ball drop. Shoot it with the lightning staff and then head to Agartha, place the staff in the pedestal, feed 20 zombies, and you're done. The final staff speed tutorial is for the ice staff. Again, here's the quick reference guide. It will be on the website, and I'll have this website linked down in the description. The location for the record is going to be around generator 2 in this room. You just go downstairs. The first record is going to be as you enter. There's going to be one by the mystery box and another by the tank station doorway. The next step is to get the staff pieces, and these are only obtained through the dig piles, and you have to wait until it is snowing before you can start digging to actually uncover these pieces. Now use the gramophone and go to generator 6, go down the tunnel and open up that portal, go into Agartha and pick up the ice staff crystal. Now go to the bottom of excavation, build and pick up the ice staff, head back into Agartha, and you're going to shoot these stones that correspond with these symbols to turn them to unlock this step. Now go back outside and using the ice staff, shoot these tombstones to freeze them and then use a bullet gun to break the tombstones. You cannot use a ray gun for this step. One location is by generator 4 and Jug. There's a footprint. The other one is below excavation and the last tombstone is all the way on the other end by tank station 2. Now head to the bottom of excavation and turn the dials till you have the blue stones and you're going to see the blue ball drop down. Shoot that with the ice staff. Head over to Agartha. Place the staff in the pedestal. Feed 20 zombies and you're done. But I hope this helped you guys out, and thanks for watching.